Hello and welcome to the Christmas Eve service at the United Church of Haworth. We are glad that you are here. By tomorrow at this time, all the presents will be opened, all the wrappings will be trashed, and for many people, Christmas will be over. We've been dealing with it since October, and for many people, they will be delighted when this tomorrow is done. However, if we focus on the celebration of the gift that we've been given in Jesus Christ, Christmas is not the end. It's really the beginning. The gift of Jesus in our world changed everything. And the gift of Jesus in our lives does the same. So bring yourselves fully into this place and fully into these moments. Hear again the great good news of Jesus' birth. Bask in the glory of the angels' announcement. And kneel with the shepherds at the manger of the King. O come, all ye faithful. O come and behold him. O come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord.
Adeste fidele, lati triumphante, venite, venite in Bethlehem. Notum vedete regem angelorum, venite adoremus, venite adoremus, venite adoremus,
Now join me in English as we sing, O Come All Ye Faithful, all four verses. The words are up on the screen.
Oh,
Normally, I do the children's message, but tonight we have a special treat. Tonight, you're going to hear the story of the little drummer boy.
Today, we're going to read the little drummer boy.
Come, they told me, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum. Our newborn king to see, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum. Our finest gift to bring, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum. To lay before the king, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum. Rum-pa-pum-pum, rum-pa-pum-pum. So to honor him, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum, when we come. Baby Jesus, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum. I am a poor boy too, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum. I have no gifts to bring, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum, that's fit to give a king, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum, pum-pa-pum, rum-pa-pum-pum, rum-pa-pum-pum. Shall I play for you, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum, on my drum? Mary nodded, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum. The ox and lamb kept time, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum. I played my drum for him, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum. I played my best for him, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum. Rum-pa-pum-pum, rum-pa-pum-pum. Me and my drum.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
We move now to our time of lighting the Advent wreath. As we have made our way through the season of Advent, we have lit candles representing hope, love, joy, and peace. Hope invites us to prepare room for a Savior. Love challenges us to employ songs proclaiming Jesus' reign. Joy calls us to allow the blessings of God to flow through us and onto the world. Peace guides us to work for the rule and the reign of Christ, here and now. Tonight, we light the Christ candle. Come, putting together our season of preparation by coming together for celebration.
The prophet Isaiah foretold the day when the people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. The dawn of that day broke into the world in the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus, whose birth we celebrate tonight and tomorrow on Christmas Day.
That dawn broke for the shepherds working the night shift as the glory of God appeared in a company of angels proclaiming the news that a Savior was born. Good news of great joy and a gift of peace for all people. After meeting the tiny Savior for themselves, the shepherds returned to their fields to repeat the sounding joy that Jesus, the promise and presence of God, had come. Tonight, as we worship, and in the days ahead, may our lives too repeat the sounding joy. Let us pray together. Glory to you, O God, who came to be with us in Jesus, about whose birth we join the angels to sing. Kindle in us all the hope, the joy, the love, and the peace that comes from meeting Jesus, not only in the manger, but in every moment and every place in which we find ourselves. Amen. Please join us now in the singing of Joy to the World. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. His right hand and his holy arm have worked salvation for him. The Lord has made his salvation known and revealed his righteousness to the nations. He has remembered his love and his faithfulness to Israel. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our God. Christ is born today. Repeat the sounding joy. Let us pray together. No matter what gifts we may receive, they all pale in comparison to the gift of Jesus. In one tiny little package, you gave the world everything that it needed, and you gave us peace, hope, love, and joy. Tonight we come to kneel at the manger and to celebrate the best gift ever. Meet us here in these holy moments. In Christ we pray. Amen. Please listen now to our praise team as they sing the songs of this season of praise.
Oh, little town of Bethlehem, how still we see lie above the thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Yet in thy dark sleep shineth the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight. How silently the wondrous gift is given. So God imparts to human hearts the blessings of His heaven. We hear the Christmas angels the great glad tidings tell. Oh, come to us, abide with us, our Lord Emmanuel. Hear His coming, but in this world of sin, where meek souls will receive Him, the dear Christ enters
forever.
Thank you, praise team, for your fine music tonight. Thank you. Our first lesson tonight comes from the prophet Isaiah, chapter 9, verses 2 through 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in the land of deep darkness, on them has light shined. Thou hast multiplied the nations, thou hast increased its joy. They rejoice before thee as with joy at the harvest, as men rejoice when they divide the spoil. For the yoke of his burden, and the staff for his shoulder, the rod of his oppressor, thou hast broken as on the day of Midian. For every boot of the trampling warrior in battle tumult, and every garment rolled in blood, will be burned as fuel for the fire. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder. And his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace there will be no end, upon the throne of David and over his kingdom, to establish it and to uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time forth and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. Let us prepare our hearts for prayer on this night. O Lord, on Christmas Eve, we come to you online and a few of us gathered here. And we think of other Christmas Eves in our lives. Some of them gathered in a worship service. Some of times shoulder to shoulder. Sometimes the biggest attendance of the whole year. And this year is different. But what's not different is your love and your steadfastness for us. So God, as we worship differently this year, we thank you that even though we are not together, you are always with us. You promise never to fail us or forsake us, never to abandon us. We remember the words of, "Lo, I'm with you always, even to the end of the age." So God, on this night when we celebrate the coming of your birth, we give you thanks and praise. We've been waiting in anticipation, and we as a people know a lot about waiting this year. And we're waiting even now for the delivery of vaccines, the time when tiers of restrictions will be lifted, when people will be able to go back to work. We're waiting for a lot of things, but we know that you're with us, and that helps. It helps an awful lot. Our Lord, we would pray that you would help us this night to worship you in spirit and in truth. We pray that as your forgiven and loved people, you would hear our prayers for those who are in need this night. We think of those like Mary and Joseph and the baby Jesus who had nowhere to go. For those who are homeless and hurting, we pray especially. We pray, O God, for the generosity of those like the innkeeper who said, "Well, you can stay in my stable." O God, for those people and agencies that seek to help, to meet the needs of those in need, we give you thanks. We thank you, O God, that there are people who are working hard to make things better for a lot of folks. This Christmas Eve, we pray for those soldiers, sailors, airmen, Marines, Coast Guardsmen, all over the world who aren't at home this year. We also pray for those who are separated because of distance and so many other reasons this year. Help us, O God, in this time to look to you for hope, for love, for joy, for peace. Help us, O God, to focus on Jesus, who came to be our Christ, our Savior, our Lord. These prayers and others deepen our hearts. We lift you in the name of Jesus, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. I want to take a special moment tonight to talk with you about the candles. For as long as I can remember, on Christmas Eve, we always had a candlelight Christmas Eve service. But no one ever explained to me why. Why do we do that? Well, because we've always done it, Carl. Tonight, I'd like to talk to you a little bit about some of our candles. Now, you understand, and we've talked about and had liturgy about the Advent candles, the candles representing hope and love and joy and peace, and the center candle being the Christ candle. It was kind of the countdown to Christmas, and we're there. The candles on the communion table are lit every Sunday, and they are signifying to me the humanity and the divinity of Jesus. They are there because we need to be reminded that Jesus came as the God-man. And on this night, on Christmas Eve, remembering that Jesus is God and man at the same time is a way in which we remember it, in a way we can see it with our eyes. The candles also move with the wind within this building. Reminds us also of the Holy Spirit. You'll see the candles behind me, the candelabra with seven candles. I like to think of those as the apostles' candles. Now, some of you are saying, now, wait a minute. I went to Sunday school. There was only 12 apostles and you got 14 candles. Do the math. Well, here's how I do the math. The 12 apostles, and then there was an apostle named Matthias, who replaced Judas, and then there was the apostle Paul. I think it's important that those candles are lit tonight to remind us of those who found Jesus Christ, who said, I am the light of the world, and the light came part of their lives, and it did something, it changed them. Now, on the east and the west windows, we have some lights, because those disciples, those apostles, went out to the world. They went to the east, they went to the west and the north and the south. They went out and spread the light of Jesus. Only light can dispel darkness. And so, on Christmas Eve, when the people who walked in darkness have seen a great light, Jesus is that great light. I hope that this explanation will help you as we worship in this candlelight service. Hear now the story from Luke chapter 2, verses 1 through 20. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that the whole world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment when Quirinius was governor. All went to be enrolled, each to his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the city of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to be delivered. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in the manger because there was no place for them in the inn. And in that region, there were shepherds out in the field keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with fear. And the angel said to them, do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy, which will come to all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among men with whom he is pleased. When the angels went away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, let's go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us. And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they saw it, they made known the saying which had been told them concerning this child. And all who heard it wondered at what the shepherds told them. But Mary kept all these things, pondering them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all that they had heard and seen as it had been told them. May God add his blessing in the reading and the hearing and the application of this, his most holy word. Amen. Being a shepherd has to be the most boring job in the whole world. Sure, once you have the sheep in a good field where they can feed on the grass, and there's a still pond where they can get a drink, and there's a sheep pen where they can go in at night, other than keeping your eyes peeled as a shepherd for any kind of predator, it's the most boring job in the world. I mean, sometimes when you're having trouble sleeping, what do we tell people? Count sheep. Can you imagine doing that for a living? And don't we understand the shepherd's lament? Don't we understand what it's like to be bored? On Friday, the 18th of December, was the last day for the boys and girls in our school to have class, and then they started their Christmas break. Here it is, the 24th of December, and I suspect, even now, that some of you who have children and grandchildren have already heard, "I'm bored. There's nothing to do." And there's that sense where the children have got out of their routine. There was a time to get up. There was a time to get on the computer to do classes. There were assignments to do. And now that structure is gone. And they don't go back to school until the 5th of January. But we've been bored too. Some of us who have retired miss seeing the people at work. We don't miss getting up and going to work, but we miss the people. We miss the interactions. We miss the structure in our lives, that this is the time we're going to get up, and this is the time we're going to do this, and this is the time we're going to get paid, and all those kind of structured things. And sometimes when we're bored, it's about our attitude. It's about our actions. What we're doing isn't what we want to be doing. And how we're feeling isn't how we want to be feeling. I remember as a boy being bored and saying so out loud, and I was given a choice. I could either clean something or I could find something to do. I had to take a different action. And so the disciples, the shepherds are watching their sheep. Oh, that'd be real exciting. Huh? And they're bored. And it's another night, same old, same old. Nothing ever happens out here, just watching the sheep, keeping an eye out for lions and bears and wolves, but other than that, nothing much ever happens. And if anything does happen, it's a predator, until that night. And so we have a group of shepherds who are bored, and we understand that. And suddenly they're not bored anymore. Their attitudes change because suddenly they see an angel, which is out of the ordinary. That doesn't happen every day. And so these very bored shepherds see an angel and become very scared, fearful. And the angel says the first thing angels say every time they appear in the Bible, "Don't be afraid." And then they hear the message, "Behold, I bring you good news of great joy, which will be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign unto you. You shall find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes." That's not so out of the ordinary. Baby wrapped in baby clothes. But lying in a manger. A baby lying in a feed stall. Please. That is a significant sign. So after these bored and scared shepherds hear this, they become curious. And they take a new action. Not whining about how bored they are, how it's the same thing over and over again. Their curiosity gets the better of them, and they take action, and they do something, and they move quickly to go to Bethlehem and see if this is honestly true. I'm sure it was interesting for the shepherds as they got into Bethlehem and said, "Hey, do you know anybody who's had a baby?" And they had to search. And they went in and they found the Christ child. They take the action and then they find him. And it is exactly as it has been told them. It has been a prophecy to them, a message to them that has been fulfilled. And it's true. It is honestly true. What we heard out in the field being bored out of our brains is now true. It's absolutely true. And once that happens, they start to tell not just Mary and Joseph. Read the passage carefully. Everybody they saw. They told everybody they could see about this. We were out in the field. We were bored. And suddenly there was an angel. And the angel told us to come to Bethlehem. And there was a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. And we found it. It's true. The angel told us the truth. We found the one who's going to be the Messiah. And they had to be fired up. Pretty excited. God had given them a message. And now they're telling it. Now, Mary ponders it and keeps it in her heart. Now, sometimes we would really like for Christmas to hang out a lot longer. There are some people who love Christmas. Matter of fact, it's going to be a while before some people take down their Christmas tree. And of course, there are those people who put their Christmas tree up pretty early. There are some people who just really, really like Christmas. And they don't want it ever to be over. But the shepherds, who had been bored and scared and curious, and people who had taken action and saw, is this really true, had to go back, had to return. But they didn't go back the same way. They didn't go back scared, and they didn't go back bored, and they didn't go back the way they were. They encountered Jesus and believed what was told them, and they were different from the inside out. Their lives were transformed. They went back rejoicing and glorifying in what God had told them. And on this Christmas Eve, we've heard the story again. And the question is it going to be true for you? Are our lives transformed because of what Jesus Christ has done and the fact that he came that we might have salvation? Are you different from the inside out? It's true. It's true. For those of us who have found it and seek to live it out each day, it's true. And it can be true for you on this very holy night. May God work in your life, touch your heart, touch your mind, and may you never be the same again. Amen. . 2020 has been an interesting year in a lot of different ways, but we're not the first people to ever have some challenges. In 1818, which is the same year Illinois became a state, in 1818, in Austria, a river flooded. And when the river flooded, it damaged the organ in the church. And because the organ was damaged, they couldn't have a Christmas Eve service. So the pastor had written a poem about Silent Night. And so he went to his musician of the church and said, "Since we can't use the organ, compose, mind you, today, before the evening service, a melody that we can sing this song to." So tonight, since 1818, like many Christians around the world, we take some time on guitar to hear and to sing Silent Night.
sleep in heavenly peace.
Next year, in 2021, my hope and my prayer is that this congregation will be gathered here live, in person, packing the pews, raising the roof, and singing Silent Night, bathed in candlelight. I live with that hope. I hope you do too. Receive the benediction. As the shepherds returned to their fields, glorifying and praising God for all that they had heard and seen, we too cannot simply stay here and worship in the manger. So go, returning to those places God has planted you, repeating the sounding joy of the angel's words, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to whom God's favor rests. Amen. God bless you. Merry Christmas. Thank you.